This isn't a short, but it's not long either. I've been running simulations of a new geometry for microwave dielectric lens antennas to fit round waveguide feeds at 10 GHz. The stepped section fits inside the waveguide tube and matches the impedance of the guide to the impedance of the filled bore. Then once outside the tube, the tapered section modifies the wavefronts and provides a match to the 377 ohm characteristic impedance of free space. The effect's to focus the beam a little and reduce the side lobes of the antenna system. It's also neat because it fills the face of the waveguide tube and can be cemented in place to prevent water ingress. It's a nice simple little turning job using high-rate polished carbide inserts for aluminium. The material's Rexolite 1422, which is a cross-linked polystyrene. It machines nicely as long as you don't push it too hard, but the main thing is that the dielectric loss is absolutely tiny. The tan delta is around about 0.00066 at 10 GHz, and it's got a dielectric constant of 2.53. The density is about the same as water, so it's not ridiculously heavy either. I've set the compound at 13.5 degrees to give me the 27 degree included angle for the taper. The truncated tip of the tapered section is approximately the same diameter as a 377 ohm dielectric waveguide. And that's also the characteristic impedance of free space for electromagnetic waves. Another geometry I've been trying is adding a half-wave parallel section at the tip to see if that provides an even better match. Rexolite polishes remarkably well using WD-40 and Scotch-Brite. I'll be making a proper video about dial spike lenses sometime later in the year. I'll put a link to that video once it's made. Meantime, YouTube thinks you might like this one.